Hi there, we're gonna talk about the four components of a loan. And I'm gonna use an analogy will help kind of bring how they all work together into one good concept, is that a loan has four tires on it, just like a car has four tires on it. And it can be a Porsche or a Lamborghini, and if it's missing a tire, or if it has an emergency tire on it, that's a smaller one, that emergency tire is gonna limit how far and how fast that vehicle can go. No matter, all the rest of it is awesome. So every mortgage, I want you to picture this, every mortgage is a car going down the road with one small tire on it. And my job is to find out which one of these four items is your smallest tire, because that will limit how much money you can borrow to buy the house with. So let's get into it for just a second. Number one is credit. Credit is your credit score and your credit history. When you're buying a house, you really only need to have one trade line that's positive and open that you've had for 2 years. So one for two and one trade line for 1 year. That can be a credit card. Usually we prefer a credit card because the bank can't come back and recollect the jeans that you bought or the groceries that you bought or the trip to Disney World. They can come back and repossess a car, right? So credit cards are actually more valuable on a mortgage than car loans or any other kind of loan because they show your true attitude about your credit history and your credit. Number two is income. Income can come from employment. It can come from disability. It can come from Social Security. It can be a pension. It can be child support, alimony, separate maintenance. There's tons of income. The main thing is that we have to see a paper trail on it. If you're self-employed, that means tax returns. Usually 1 year. A lot of times it can be 2 years, but 1 year for sure on income. Number three is down payment. There's only one or two loans that don't require down payment. USDA loans do not. You gotta live, I don't wanna say in the woods, but almost in the woods. But there's some places around Metro Atlanta that USDA loans are available, and I do those. Also VA loans, I do a ton of those. Those two loans don't require down payment. Most of the rest of the loans out there require a down payment, either 3%, 3.5%, 5%. But there's some type of down payment involved. We'll talk about what's specific to you, but just trying to get the big concept out. Number four is you have to have some money left over in the bank after closing that we can see that's there before closing. So we don't want you to spend all your money just trying to buy the house. You have to have savings. We technically call that reserves. We just call it rainy day money. Basically, you need to have some money left over. Most people are good with that because they want to have some. What we're looking for there is 1 or 2 months of your new house payment. So $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 bucks usually covers that requirement. Thank you so much for watching. We'll talk to you again soon.